We have a new feature called New Customer Accounts that lets your customers log in to view their orders, profile information, and saved addresses. It's not talked about too much right now, but its features are pretty cool. All right, everyone, Christian here. Let me show you how to enable and use the new customer accounts on Shopify. So you might be wondering what's different, because you've had the ability to do customer accounts, but they've sort of revamped that section. So now you have the sort of classic customer accounts and you have these new customer accounts, which I would probably highly suggest to move to the new customer accounts, because I think they're gonna start rolling out some cool features specifically for the new customer accounts. So your customers can now log in without having to have a password. So when they log in for the first time, their customer account is created automatically. So you don't have to worry about necessarily dealing with all that. And you can't also deactivate an individual customer account once they sort of create it. It's actually really nice, because they just go in, they put in their email, and then it will send them that one-time code. And then after that, because that email is attached to whatever orders they've had with your account, then they'll be able to see all of their orders, history, their addresses, shipping, and all that kind of stuff. Now, before we proceed, bienvenidos. I am Christian Piñon, co-founder here at Bit Branding. It's an e-commerce growth agency. We specialize in helping clothing stores grow and scale profitably online. Don't miss out on our new weekly videos. So hit subscribe, turn on notifications to stay in the loop. So let's go in here and see exactly where we can find these new features. So if you go to settings and then you'll go to checkout and accounts. So this is all standard, right? They haven't had any changes here necessarily, but inside of here, now if you scroll down, some marketing options, abandoned checkout, post purchase, you'll see customer accounts right here. And then you'll see a new tab that says account experience. Now with the account experience, this will sort of tell you how you're able to do your accounts right now. So right now the login link shown in online store and checkout. So we have an actual login on our store, and the version we're using, the classic customer accounts. Now, more than likely, if you're an older store, it will say the classic customer accounts. If you're newer, like you just set it up last week or last month, it might say the new customer accounts. But even if you're on the classic, you can definitely change this to the new one. So all you have to do is click on edit here, and then right within here, it'll give you the option to do the new customer accounts. And this is where the customers will log in with that one-time code sent to their email. And then as far as the login experience, okay. Yeah, I think the other check mark here is require customers to log in before checking out. I probably wouldn't suggest something like that. And then next up here, we have the customer account URLs. So it actually gives you the URLs for your accounts. As you can see, the classic was actually tied directly into your particular store as far as how the URL looks. So it was like the, for example, this one, the domain.net/account/login. For new customer accounts, you have the shopify.com/the number, which that number I'm guessing ties back to the actual either store or account. And this is how they basically sign up with that one-time code. Hey, really quickly, if you're tired of designing stores from scratch and having to figure it out all yourself, we have a new website VIP day process. And if you're interested, just as it sounds, it's a website, a whole Shopify website in one day. If you're interested, please check the link in the description below for more information. Now, I do want to say that the new customer accounts, you are able to change the domain here. So you are able to do something like what we call like subdomains. So that's where you essentially replace a www at the beginning and change it for something else. So for example, the most common is going to be something like account.bitbranding.com, for example. That way, it's more branded to your store, which I would probably also recommend doing something like this. Now, if you want to see a preview of the classic and the new, I can show you right here. So let's look at the classic. So the classic has sort of lives inside of your store, right? So you have all your navigation, all of your things right there, and you have just a classic email, password, sign in right there. Obviously with your footer that you sort of, you know, built inside of the customizer. Now the new customer accounts, they look completely different. And they're sort of what I think it's more of the, you know, part of the checkout, where like in the checkout page, there's like minimal things that you can change and address within there. It's the same thing with these new account pages, where literally right now, as of right now, the recording of this video, all we can do really is change the logo. And you can't even change the logo to be specific for this page, you would have to change the logo on your checkout page. So this is really taking into consideration what you have currently on your checkout page, and it just basically translates it and grabs it over here. So I think it also grabs some of the colors. So the I think the button colors, it does grab and put it over here. Now, if you don't know how to change that, then it's just really quickly. You go over to your online store, customize. And actually, this is something a lot of people do miss because it's just not inherently clear that you need to do it this way. So theme settings, and then from within here, you have checkout. And then right here, we have the logo that we can change. And then we have some of the background colors, accents and buttons and things like that that you can change. So that's about it really. You can change, font colors, and then background colors, and the logo image essentially. But just know that this logo image that is set up for your checkout page is the one that will be used for your new customer account. Now, this is basically how it would look for your customers too. Obviously, like, I don't have any orders necessarily placed right here, but it will show all of their orders right within here. And it also will show their account information. So whatever addresses they have saved within their account information that we'll have in here, they will also have an opportunity to make any changes that they need to make with their email or name, etc. And this is my prediction, right? Is that they're gonna start adding features to this. So that's the reason why they're sort of jumping from the classic to this new. And what I would suggest for you to change from classic to the new, one, it's gonna make it so much easier for the customer to create the account. I mean, you just put your email in there and it just sends you that code, you put it in there, and then you have all your information right there. So it's pretty secure there. And then the other thing is that they will probably start adding some new features to this, and they have already started adding some features to this. And that new feature is customer account actions. As you can see this section right here, as I said, they're gonna start doing or having the ability for the customers to actually make different actions, right, within your store, and for you to be able to either allow or deny, right? So right now, the very first one that we have here is customer self-serve return, which at some point Shopify had return magic, I think it was what it was called. They got rid of it on the app store, and this is why they sort of built in or baked in that feature right within the settings here. So now we have the ability for the customer to log into their account and actually submit the return process right from within there. So there's no sort of third party other logins that they have to go to in order to view that. And as you can see here, all we have to do is really is just check mark that. So allow customers to self-serve returns. Obviously they have if you click on the learn more, you can definitely find out more information about these new self-serve returns, setting them up, managing, etc. Now, a few things that I will definitely warn you and make sure that you have set up on these new customer accounts. You do have the refund policy, privacy policy, terms of service, and all these things down here at the bottom. These are automatically created based on the settings on the policies page. So I think a lot of people do confuse or have actually these two, and I've seen it firsthand multiple times, where you have your pages where you have your policies living there, and then you also have the policy page where you have them living in there too. So in order to make sure that you manage that correctly, and I just want to just showcase that real quick, you have right within here within the settings, you have the policies right here at the bottom. And then as you can see, we have text in here. And then technically these things that you filled out right here for the refund, privacy, etc., you can link to your navigation. But a lot of people, what they do is they go to here, they go to online store, and they go to pages, and then they create the shipping and returns, and they recreate the pages again over here, and then link them to the navigation. You don't have to necessarily do this step right here, which is adding them to the pages right within here. You can just leave it within the settings and then policies, and then link them that way. Anytime that Shopify gives you that option, same with, like, for example, brand is something that's a little bit newer, but make sure that you're setting up your logo and your colors and everything right within the brand section too, because a lot of times and a lot of these new features, they're going to be grabbing information from here and then putting them into other places in your store. So it's important to make sure that you keep track of the brands, policies, etc. in there. But I'll put this link in the description as well, where it talks more about the customer self-serve returns and how all that works, because it's super interesting. You also have, like, the notifications and emails and things like that, which will go through setting notification and look up for the returns. Super interesting. Customer accounts, something that I think a lot of people at some point really wanted. They've sort of navigated to apps right? And now Shopify is sort of bringing it back internally. I think that they're gonna keep adding more features. So I would definitely suggest to switching over to the new customer accounts, testing it out for you and your customers, seeing how they like it. If you want, you can turn on the customer self-serve returns and see how that works for you. But yeah, pretty excited. New Shopify update. We'll go with that. Now, if you're interested in more videos about Shopify new updates, make sure to watch this one next. This one? This way? This way, maybe. Yeah, one of those ones. See ya.